Ready and away. From the inside, Saintly City, Defiant Diorite, the first of them to leave. King Advisor right out near the middle of the course, building speed. Apache Blue driving up there. From close at hand, Banks Avenue, Zangief, Magnasonic, all racing very close handy. From Rocket Juice, Stablemate, Zubolts outside of it in the early part. From Storm Leader and Royal Gap last. King Advisor continues to pour it on and comes across from out in the deep. King Advisor goes up, goes to the lead. Banks Avenue follows it around the outside of the field. Strode to second from Saintly City. Apache Blue running fourth. Zangief is fifth and three and four deep on the track. Hugging the inner part of the course is close at hand. Behind them, Defiant Diorite. Magnasonic followed further back behind those. Then Rocket Juice. Zubolt's particularly wide. Then Royal Gap Storm Leader at the top of the home straight. Now Banks Avenue sails to the lead. Banks Avenue shot two clear. Zangief looming down the outside. Apache Blue, Saintly City close at hand over towards the inside. Banks Avenue at the 150s, the leader getting up on the inside, close at hand, wider out, Rocket Juice, Royal Gap, Banks Avenue kept going, down the outside, Royal Gap, Banks Avenue's in front, Banks Avenue just wins from Royal Gap, tight third, close at hand, or Rocket Juice, then Apache Blue, behind those pulling up next of all is Saintly City, in behind them, Zubolt, Storm Leader, Magnasonic, well back in the field with Defiant Diorite, Zangief compounding, as did the pacemaker King Advisor. So Banks Avenue gets the job done here. Brandon Louis for trainer Gino Paletti, the Awesome Rock 5-year-old. Banks Avenue back from 19 into $8, in fact $7.50 before starting $8.50 on the WOP and land the prize here in the fourth. Royal Gap coming down the outskirts of the course to grab second. Third is five, close at hand, and nose in front of Rocket Juice. The placings interim, 4-12-5-7. Banks Avenue. Gino Paletti, Brandon Louis combining here for Mrs. BJ Paletti, Madame's Thompson, Pegas, Roe, Dargan, Strathdy, Winfield, Newman, and Hutchinson. And post its third win in 19, and they didn't forget to back it this afternoon. Banks Avenue form is better than it reads on paper, and it's got the money, winning by a short neck in 1:15, 1:04. The track really getting on the heavy side now. It's a heavy 8, 37.74, and becoming a real grind out there at the moment. A short neck, a length and a half for the margins. Royal Gap first up, second in by King's Troop from Gaps in Me Knees, Ash Maley, Lakdar Romilly, and five close at hand by Impending from Miss Supersonic, Grant and Delana Williams, Willie Pike combining. 4-12-5-7 here, numbers after the running of the fourth on the program. But a big go here, Banks Avenue, targeted in the betting, 19 into 7.50, jumping officially 8.50. The McMahon Handicap for Fillies and Mares is the next at 3.35 over 1,200 with 11 and 12. I'm a single gallon, Charlie Jane, the scratchings. Let's go downstairs to Lockie Taylor. And Lock, this horse's form is certainly much, much better than it might read numerically.
Absolutely, Darren, and that's why you're the wise man that tipped this horse at around 20 to 1, but punters didn't forget to back him late, and winning trainer Gino Paletti joins me now. Gino, Banks Avenue, is it fair to say this horse has just been building into his campaign nicely, finally gets a race run to suit and gets the conditions that he clearly relishes?
He does, and he's very unlucky in the provincials twice. You know, he got pushed around in the straight and all that sort of stuff. And so I didn't give Brandon any instructions today. He knows him a bit now, so... Because sometimes he jumps that quick, you can't hold him back.
And that's exactly what happened today. From the outset, he was immediately outside the leader. And yeah, in this heavy going, he just travelled so well.
He did. He just loves it. Yeah. So hopefully we can get another track like this in a couple of weeks.
What have you made of the horse throughout his career? He's a cracking type to look at in the yard. Is he the type of horse that, provided he gets conditions to suit throughout these winter months, that can go through the grades to some extent?
Yeah, I reckon he can. He can run time. So, you know, I think there's to go up into, you know, win another two or three races and then see how we go, whether we aim him at something. But, yeah, we'll just let him tell us.
Sounds like a nice plan, and he's a nice horse. Well done.
So, hi to your sister too.
Yes, I will, without doubt.
She was on it.
She was on it. There you go. Oh, congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
There's Gino Paletti after the win of Banks Avenue, and here's Brandon Louis catching up with Scotty.
Brandon's going to join me now. Brandon, this horse is a previous heavy track winner, but it took every little bit of effort to get through that.
Yes, I think probably among all the horses I've been riding for everybody, I think that one has been every time unlucky. We got cut out Bunbury last time, then Novum, we got no run. But today it was just playing out nice. We jumped. I got stuck a bit wide, but I know his speed, so he just went a bit forward, just sit there. And he was pretty tough, heavy track, so yeah.
Looked like it was the difference early, because there were lots of horses that wanted a similar spot, but you were the one that was able to bully your way to that spot.
Yeah, exactly. I was sort of aware that probably there's my horse only and Apache, something that got a bit of a heavy track form. And I know, if I'm there and I sort of put a gap on them, when we start to climb in the mud, I'll probably be up there, you know what I mean? But I want to say thank you very much, Gino. Biffany was big supporters of mine, and I dedicate that winner to my good mate. He's back on Saturday, Sean O'Donnell. Very good, mate.
Congratulations, well done.
Thanks, mate.
There's Brandon Louis combining with Gino Paletti and Banks Avenue to take out the Key Clean Handicap.